Hi, it's Sherry from A Quilting Life. Welcome back to part two of the Dresden Plate tutorial. Last time we did the bottom part of the Dresden Plate and I showed you how to cut the Dresden blades and how to sew them together to where you had the base for your Dresden unit. Today we're going to make the circle. So we're going to be doing this part of the Dresden Plate block. Now, I really, really like to use a template for my circles. And there are some pre-made templates called Perfect Circles and Bigger Perfect Circles. These are pre-cut acrylic round-shaped templates that you can use for making circles of all different sizes. For the Dresden plate block that we are doing, we will be using one of the templates from the Bigger Perfect Circles collection. And I'll just give you a quick peek at those. They have some really big circles that you can use. If you don't have access to these templates and you want to make your own, I'm going to show you quickly a way that you can make your own templates. This is a freezer paper template. And it's made from several different layers of plain freezer paper that you can just get at your grocery store. And the coated side of the freezer paper, the shiny paper side, will iron to the flat side, the non-coated side. And I usually put about three or four layers together, trace my design and cut it out to make a freezer paper template. So if you want to make a freezer paper template for your circle, you can. This, for the 2.5 inch blades that we did in the last video, a 3.5 inch diameter circle works great. So this is a 3.5 inch diameter. I've chosen my center circle fabric and I'm going to trace around my template on the wrong side of the fabric. See if I can get the pen to work. Okay, so once I have my circle drawn, I'm going to cut out, but I'm not going to cut on the line. I'm going to leave about 3/8 of an inch all the way around the drawn line. And I'm not going to worry about getting it too perfect. You'll see why in a minute. But I do need to leave room at least 1/4 to 3/8 of an inch all the way around. Okay, once I have it, I am going to actually take a needle and thread and I'm going to sew a running stitch around this section. And I'm not going to be real particular about it again. I have a knot. I'm going to put the knot right there. And then I'm just going to do a simple gathering stitch or running stitch around the rest of the template. So just keep continuing around with the running stitch until you get within 1/4 of an inch of where you began your stitch. So as you get close to the knot, you want to make sure that your needle comes up on the wrong side of the fabric. Now at this point I want to tell you a trick that you can do if your fabric is kind of sheer and you're worried about the blades of the Dresden showing through the fabric. You can actually just use some plain white fabric or even some plain white interfacing. Cut a circle shape, and if you're using interfacing, just put it in there or the circle shape. You'll cut this one out directly on the line. You won't leave the extra fabric. But that way, if you have a sheer fabric, you can back it with something so that it's not as sheer. Okay, when you get to the end, insert your template, put it back on top, and pull this thread. And what you're going to do is you're going to gather the fabric around the edges of your template. And that's why these bigger circle perfect circle templates work so well. The template plastic they're made of is thick, and it really helps you to gather the fabric. And the same thing when you use the freezer paper template, that's why you want to use several layers of freezer paper so that you have kind of an edge. If you look on the other side, I've got a really good circle with smooth edges because I've pulled this fabric. Now, the next step is to take this over to the ironing board and iron it. And that's the other good thing about this plastic. The iron won't affect it. And the same thing with the freezer paper templates. The iron won't affect it. So I'm going to take this over to the ironing board. Sometimes I use a tiny bit of spray starch around the edges, and I'm going to iron it, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've ironed the edges down. I've still got my knot and my thread. At this point, I'm going to tie a knot in my thread and cut off the end of the thread. Then I'm going to just quickly pull the template out, and you can tell that I still have my perfect circle shape, and it's ready now to be appliqued to the center of my Dresden block. Perfect circles every time using this method. I'm going to show you just a couple of other things. I've got another block that I have ready to stitch down. Generally, I take my fabric for the background, the square, and I fold it into fourths, and I will lightly press it with the iron so that I have little lines that I can use to line up the Dresden block so that I get it centered on the square. So I've got, in this example, I've got the two press lines right here and the two press lines pretty close to right here. And I use these little applique pins to stitch, to hold the Dresden in place while I do the hand stitching. They're by Clover. They are just the perfect size for applique. And I generally will pin my block to the background fabric. And I generally stitch the block on the bottom part of the plate. I stitch this part on before I add the circle. I just have this one all pinned to show you for an example. But I will sew this onto the background fabric, and then I will sew the circle on top. So that's the technique for making a Dresden plate block. The technique is the same regardless of what size blade you use. Okay, that's the tutorial for the Dresden plate block. All you have left to do is applique your block, and you'll have a finished Dresden plate block. They're perfect to make in any size, and I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you missed the first part, be sure to go back and watch it, and I would love it if you'd subscribe to the YouTube channel so you get all the updates when I post new tutorials. And thanks so much for stopping by.